Meet our pawn. He just stepped out of his house into a graph-like city. At every intersection, he hesitates and lets the dice decide his path. He keeps going node after node until home is far behind. But here's the question, will he ever return? Is it inevitable, or could he wander this infinite city forever? In this video, we will explore how our pawn behaves in different dimensions. First, let's make our pawn wander a small finite town, where there is just a dozen of nodes. As our intuition tells us, he is guaranteed to return. Mathematically, we say probability 1. We can calculate the probability of us landing on a node. Each turn, we will be traveling through an edge to a node. So the total number of outcomes is 2 times the total number of edges. Of these, the favorable ones are those that land on our home node, so the degree of our home node. In the example graph displayed here, degree of home is 6, while there are 44 edges. So the steady state fraction is 6 over 88, approximately 7%. Since this interval is finite for any finite connected graph, the pawn still returns home with probability 1. And it's important to clarify, this is not the probability of landing at home on each turn, but rather the percentage of time the pawn will spend at home with enough time. Now, imagine the town keeps going forever. A single road that stretches left and right without end. Our pawn stands at his house and flips a fair coin. Heads, he goes right. Tails, he goes left. Intuitively, you might think there's a chance he walks off forever and never comes back. But here's a cool fact. In one dimension, he will come back home with probability 1. Eventually, he will stand on that doorstep again. Here's a simple proof. Let's calculate the probability of the pawn being at home after n steps. Actually, after 2 n steps, because it can't land home after an odd number of steps. If the pawn is home after 2 n steps, it means he got in his coin flips n heads and n tails. The number of those sequences is 2n choose n. There is 2 to the 2n possible sequences. So from here we get the probability of returning in 2 n steps. The larger n, the smaller the probability of returning in n steps. But the decay is pretty slow, and the series diverges to infinity, meaning the expected number of visits home is infinite. If there were a positive chance that the pawn never returns, then the expected total number of returns would be finite. But we just found that the expected number is infinite. So the only possibility is that the pawn returns with probability 1. Roughly, the chance to be at home decays too slowly, so over infinite time the visits pile up, and you are guaranteed one. I ran 100 independent walkers for the same number of steps and plotted a histogram of their positions. As we can see, they form a bell curve. The bars near zero node are taller, which means most walks stay close to the house. Occasional long trips exist, but the mass stays piled up at the origin. What if our pawn city isn't just a single line, but a whole grid of streets? A true 2D city. Well, the story is remarkably similar to the 1D case. Each step is now chosen from 4 directions instead of 2. But again, his position after many steps is just the sum of lots of tiny independent moves. By the central limit theorem, the cloud of pawns spreads out in the shape of a 2D Gaussian bell, now a hill instead of a curve. Most pawns stay clustered near their starting house, with the density slowly flattening out as time goes on. we can adapt all formulas to fit the 2D version, and we get the chance to be at home the case. Again, too slowly, because it diverges. In this case, 1 over n. And just like in one dimension, the probability of eventually coming back home is still 1. The math is different, but the intuition is the same. The chance of being exactly at home the case slowly enough that over infinite time, those returns add up. Now, let's step into a 3D city, streets in X, Y, and Z. The rules are the same. At each corner, our pawn picks one of the 6 directions at random. Well, you get the point. Just like before, after many steps, his position is the sum of lots of tiny independent moves. So the cloud of pawns looks like a 3D Gaussian hill, spreading out over time. Here's the surprise, in 3D, the peak at home shrinks fast enough that the total chance mass of being exactly home added over all times stay finite. Translation: there is a real chance he never comes back. In fact, the probability he ever returns in 3D is about 0.3405, roughly 1 in 3. So, to finally answer the question we started with, will our pawn ever return home, or drift away forever? The answer is, it depends entirely on the structure of the world. In any finite city, no matter how large, it's trapped. Return is guaranteed. In an infinite 1D line or 2D grid, it always stumbles home, eventually. The probability is 1. In an infinite 3D grid, the probability of ever returning plummets to just about 34%. There's a very real chance it's lost to the void forever. To verify the conclusions, I simulated thousands of workers for many steps. The panel you see is the 3D cumulative return curve. It rises and then plateaus at about 0.34. Roughly 1/3 ever come back, as I said earlier. My 1D simulations, by contrast, show almost everyone returning in finite time. The 2D shows how about 80% of workers get back in time. This is because sometimes, especially in 2D, it takes a lot of time, and I mean a lot of time, for workers to return home. But thanks to the math, we know they eventually will. So, as Shizuo Kakutani said, a drunk man will find his way home, but a drunk bird, he may get lost forever. If you enjoyed this little video, a like or a follow helps me make more. Thanks for watching.